Hello, and welcome back to McMaster's Demystifying Medicine YouTube channel.
We are your hosts for today's deep dive to demystify gut fermentation syndrome, also known as Auto-Brewery syndrome or ABS.
Auto-Brewery syndrome? Sounds like a hidden speakeasy from the Prohibition era.
Not quite. ABS is actually a very rare disease where the gut becomes a covert brewery fermenting the carbs you ingest into ethanol without even taking a drink. Let's look at a case study to learn more. In 2019, a 25-year-old man presented to the emergency department with complaints of dizziness, nausea, and slurred speech.
So far, this sounds like alcohol intoxication, no?
Right, but this is where it gets odd. Both he and his wife said that he had not consumed any alcohol from the previous weeks. They noticed that he would get extremely drowsy when he had his usual 12-ounce beer in the afternoon. And this only got worse. Eventually, he experienced these symptoms while he was abstaining from alcohol.
Oh, wow.
During one of these episodes was when his wife decided to bring him to the hospital. The doctors were baffled, so they did a full workup.
Interesting. What did they find?
Well, he had no prior medical or surgical history, and his physical examination didn't yield any results. So they did a urine drug test, metabolic panel, liver function tests, blood counts, and thyroid studies.
And?
Nothing. These all seemed unremarkable. However? His blood alcohol concentration was significantly elevated.
But I thought he was abstaining from alcohol.
He was, which made this finding even more mysterious. His wife decided to purchase a breathalyzer to monitor his blood alcohol concentration. She used herself as a control, consistently testing at zero blood alcohol concentration. When he tested, he kept scoring from 0.04 to 0.07% in the absence of alcohol. For reference, a typical BAC after two shots of 40% liquor is about 0.05%. In Canada, that's the typical concentration of a vodka or tequila you'd buy off the shelf. Clearly, alcohol was in his system without him consuming it. He was then given the working diagnosis of ABS.
What a fascinating case. But how does ABS even work?
In Auto-Brewery syndrome, an overgrowth of fungi and bacteria in the gut can ferment the carbohydrates you ingest into ethanol, a form of alcohol which leads to feelings of intoxication.
So, you're saying their bodies can turn bagels and pasta into booze?
Basically. In normal metabolism, the glucose and carbohydrates will be converted into ATP, which is the body's energy source. However, in ABS, the pathway changes and the glucose gets converted into ethanol.
Wait, this could be happening in my body right now?
No, it's very unlikely because it is an incredibly rare disease. Microorganisms like yeast from the Candida and the Saccharomyces families are commonly implicated in this condition and can be commensal, i.e. present in your gut flora. However, they would need to turn pathogenic in order for the conversion to alcohol to occur.
Can this yeast party be triggered by any risk factors?
Certainly, comorbidities, which means common diseases that present alongside the condition, such as obesity, type 2 diabetes, Crohn's disease, and liver issues like cirrhosis, can contribute to this.
Now, how do we fix this brewtrastrophe?
Well, in the small number of cases that do occur, the treatment is specified for the microorganism causing it. Typically, this would be antifungals or antibiotics to help manage symptoms.
So if fungi is the cause, you would give antifungals like fluconazole, nystatin, micafungin, and trichomycin B?
Yes, the patient mentioned earlier actually received fluconazole, and his symptoms resolved completely. Antibiotics can only be given if bacteria are confirmed to the cause. In certain situations, patients may be instructed to limit their carbohydrate intake and increase their protein intake.
I can't even imagine giving up my fettuccine addiction.
Well, in some cases, it can be extremely helpful, and symptoms have disappeared just from diet modifications.
Hang on, I just thought of something. What about ABS in situations like drunk driving?
Great question. Prosecuting crimes committed by individuals with ABS is an interesting topic. Drunk driving especially is a controversial one.
I mean, the patient cannot control their high levels of endogenous alcohol production, so can patients with ABS be permitted to drive or even be persecuted in the event of an accident?
Yes, this medicolegal situation brings up a lot of complicated ideas, and it only gets more complicated by the fact that it is impossible to differentiate whether the alcohol concentration was a result of ABS or voluntary alcohol consumption. Ultimately, while it's important to be aware of the fact that ABS is a possibility when prosecuting these sorts of cases, it's also important to recognize that the condition is really rare and unlikely to be acquired through something like diet. So it's not likely that we can pin your average drunk driving case on ABS.
Thank you for joining us and learning about the world's strangest happy hour. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like this video and check out the other videos on the Demystifying Medicine channel. Goodbye.